Well, I can't honestly remember like the first part of it, receiving the ball, but I just remember, you know, taking it down in line and just crossing in to see what would happen, and I got an upper 90 goal, which was pretty cool. It's pretty cool to score my first college goal on Jeffrey, so that means a lot.
When making such an accomplishment, do you ever kind of think back on all that coaches and the coaching staff and everyone has helped you prepare for that moment?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Every day, in and out, being in the gym with Greg, being on the field with coaches before and after practice, you know, it all adds up at the end. It's pretty cool.
How important is it for the defense to get on the scoring sheet in games? How much does that help the offense?
The defense?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. You know, like sometimes, you know, defense doesn't get the opportunities to get up the field. But when you do and you get those chances to cross it or, you know, score, it's a pretty big accomplishment, I think, personally. So.
On the other side of that, the offense has just been so dominant lately. How's that make your lives on the defense?
So much easier. They're able to, you know, like control the ball up there, and we don't have to, you know, run back. And it's pretty cool to watch them score. We've been really successful up top this season, so it's really exciting for the future as well.
You guys are able to control the ball a lot this game. Mm-hmm. Would you credit that more to the offense or the defense?
The midfield too. I mean, we do a really great job winning the ball in the middle of the field and being able to distribute it to both sides, and I contribute to all around the field. We like work as a team together, and I think we've done a really good job collectively keeping the ball and being calm and knowing when to attack and knowing when to sit back and just swing the ball around the field.
How much did Coach emphasize keeping up the intensity from the game on Friday?
A lot. We have to stick together as a team. We have a very long season, and if the intensity goes down, then everything goes down. So we have to keep it up, and it's starting in the middle of the season, and if we keep it up, we'll keep moving forward. So it's very important.
Big Ten Freshman of the Week last week. Is that on your mind today when going out and playing like that?
No, actually, I found out like a little bit ago. But it's a great honor, but each week something new, and you have to take it as something totally different, and you have to play each game like your own. So I kind of just let it pass and played today pretty well. So.
You guys came in as a heavy favorite today. How do you keep yourself up, and how does the rest of the team keep themselves ready for this game?
Well, we play this team like we would play any other team. We work our best. We try to get better each game. We can't take any team lightly, because with soccer, you have a bad game and you could end up losing. So we have to come in each game playing like they're the best opponent we could play.
7-0 final. It didn't look like it was going to go that way for the first 20 minutes or so. You guys just couldn't seem to get it in the back of the net. How was that mentally with you guys on the field?
It's definitely frustrating when you can't find the back of the net. I mean, taking shots and not seeing the net is very frustrating on the whole team. But once we get the one in, then the rest come. So after we got that first goal, we all settled down and just played our game and finished the rest of the six goals.
Early struggles, it seemed. I mean, the score doesn't reflect that, but it seemed like you guys had a lot of strong chances. You just couldn't get that last touch to put it away. Does that get in anyone's mind? What does that do to them?
I actually thought we fought through the frustration pretty well. You know, I think they kept their cool. They kept going at them. I thought our flank play was exceptional tonight. Both M. Hurd and Mal Weber. Petey went in there. Haley went in there. I thought we really gave them a challenge in the flank area. But I thought right off the bat, the attitude was good. The mentality was right, and I was really proud of this team's performance tonight.
How well did the team keep up the intensity from the win on Friday?
I have to tell you, I mean, we do some things, charting some different things, and I thought overall the intensity was very good. We scrambled for second balls, we fought for first balls, our passing was good, we were up around 80%, so I feel really good about tonight's performance.
As you're making it more and more into your season, you only lost one game during the Duke Classic. As a coach, how are you feeling?
You know, I think the overall feeling is very good, but one of the things I talked to the team about tonight is that I went back and watched the national championship game from yesterday, and we've got a lot of work to do. We got to continuously remind ourselves, especially when things are going well, that there's still so much more that we need to accomplish if we're going to reach our goals this year.
Would you say that plays on your one game at a time attitude you talked about previously?
Yeah, I mean, we have a plan and a schedule that hopefully will get us there by the time NCAA tournament rolls around, and we've got some real big Big Ten games coming up. Obviously, a big challenge this weekend with both Northwestern and Illinois, and I think we got ourselves in for a fight this weekend.
Coming in as a heavy favorite in this game, how do you keep your team focused and keep their minds on this game?
Well, we talk about what it is to be a competitor. And when we go out and recruit players, we look for competitive players. Obviously, there's athleticism and there's skill. But we want players that want to win in everything that they do, whether it's checkers or in the backyard in basketball or against any opponent that steps on Jeffrey Field. So credit to Bucknell. I think they kept us off the board for a while and they fought. And even when the score was starting to go up, they continued to fight. And a ton of credit to those guys.